is a fictional story, either it's legend, myth, or even local culture. Yes, that is the narrative text. Hallelujah, also. So the narrative text has four general structure, orientations, pembenaran, complications, pembenaran konflik sampai klimaks, resolutions, akhir atau kesimpulan cerita, and reorientations, pesan moral. That is the general structure of narrative text. So, sebelumnya Bapak sudah kasih tugas yaitu tentang mencari cerita dan menulis cerita narrative, writing your narrative text. So, I will choose one of you to go in front of and read the text. So, who wants to be in front of? Who wants to be? Who wants? Okay, not next, please. So, what is your story for today?
My story is the boy who cried wolf.
Okay, thank you. Please go ahead.
A farmer asked his sheep to take their hair to sheep grazing every day. Well, the boy watched over the sheep, he could work and decide to have some fun, so he sold wolf. Oh, even hearing this, the villagers had to help him change the walkway. As they reached him, they realized that there was a wolf and he was just kidding. The villagers were furious and they yelled at the boy for putting his tails and neck. The next day, the boy showed wolf again and once again the villagers came to help him and saw that there was no wolf. This made them very angry. On the same day, the boy saw an actual wolf that was terrorizing the sheep. The boy cried, "Wolf, wolf, please help me." And the villagers showed up as they believed that the boy was joking.
All right, thank you. Please have a seat. Yes, so from the story, we can know that the title is the orientation